festival, and so on. So welcome to Matrimony International Festival of Letters 2020 in association with Bhima Par Bhairavis. We MBFL 2020 is strictly following the green protocol. So I kindly request you all to avoid the plastics in our premises for a better life. So now we have a conversation on the topic, where am I? The sense of belonging and culture identities in a world on the move. And the speakers are Maggie Harris, an author, Chandrahas Chowdhury, a novelist, and Aishwarya Tharabai, a student and a poet. We'll start our session.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure it's a very hot day and we're all very hungry, but we're still here. So, Saman. So the topic that we have today is cultural identity and a sense of belonging. So I think it's important that we first talk about what identity means to each of us. What does it mean to you?
Actually carry on from the previous session in a way. It's something very fluid and something that you don't necessarily get to have the power to define yourself. But you can identify yourself, I think, by where you feel you belong. So it's maybe more constructive to look at how you define belonging and where you feel you belong. And that's what I was trying to explore. And in fact, Ramesh Gunasekara did say that people who have been displaced, writers who have a very complex relationship with identity and kind of explore this. So my book was in a way exploring each of the characters is trying to define the identity in a new way. So ultimately I created a little community within the villa of the, where all the action sort of happens, where there's acceptance, such a degree of affection and understanding that people feel truly themselves. And that is hard to define, but it's just a sense of feeling at ease and belonging. And so for me, that's what identity is.
I think as a writer, you always have at the very least two kinds of identity. There is, of course, my primary identity, the one that I represent here sitting here before we've had a chance to talk to each other, is the one I answer, the one that I answer that answers to my name. And that identity has a biography, it has a past, it has a history. You know, I'm 40 years old and I have three places in India that I think of as home, like Bombay and Bhubaneswar, and I've written about all of these. And I come from a certain place, I have a certain education, I have certain friends, and I have certain preoccupations and obsessions that are uniquely my own. But I think as a fiction writer, at least as equal, is that sense of identity that goes in the opposite direction from your first sense and wants actually to erase all things that are unique to yourself and instead melt into the rest of the world. And I think this is a very powerful impulse for writing fiction, which is the desire to enter empathetically into the worldview, point of view, or language of another person. And in that way, I feel as Indian writers, as South Asian writers, we are some of the luckiest writers anywhere in the world, because we can never run out of material. And especially at the stage of history that we live in right now, in the first decades of the third millennium, 20th century, the amount of internal diversity and new stories in our societies means that you can never run out of stories, and therefore you can never run out of possible identities as a writer. And I think for me the main pleasure of being a novelist is putting together into books different people who might not meet each other in real life, and to set up encounters in a book that, and I think this is somewhere that the South Asian novel and Indian novel is a very, very amazing work. Lots of times in early Indian novel, you see characters who inhabit dilemmas that are not necessarily exactly the same that people in society were having at the time. They're one step ahead of society. Women, for example, thinking about what it means.